Chapter 4. The Hindquarters. Hindquarters. The three ponies were at a standstill in the living room. Furlong was poised, with the mare in his hoof. Yet something was preventing him from moving on with the deed. Lyra was still mesmerized by the gadget, unaware of what hung in the balance. Just all her memories with Bon Bon. No big deal. Wait! Bon Bon broke the silence. She trotted in front of Lyra, in turn breaking her gaze from the hoof mare. Are you sure there's no other way?
I have an idea, but it requires sacrifice.
Furlong cocked his head, sizing up the mint green unicorn.
A great big one.
What is it? Bon Bon said, brightening. Her cerulean eyes grew large. Whatever it is, I'll do it. For Lyra.
Not yours, kid. Hers.
Furlong gestured at Lyra, who was blinking furiously. She looked quite confused.
If you want Lyra to keep her memories of her friendship, she'll have to join the agency, too.
He shrugged as if it were all quite simple. Business as usual. But Bon Bon normally liked that quality in him. But right now, it annoyed her. Join the agency? Lyra perked up. Together? Absolutely not! Bon Bon protested with a frown. She didn't want to drag Lyra into all of this, too. It was a dangerous life, protecting Equestria from all those monsters.
You've got 2 seconds to decide, kid.
Furlong looked at his watch.
We have to leave now.
Goodbye, Ponyville, whimpered Bon Bon. So much for the simple life, she thought, just as Lyra echoed her words much more enthusiastically. Goodbye, Ponyville! We're going undercover! Lyra gasped as she stepped onto the hoofline bridge, scanning the Manhattan skyline. Tall towers of glass and metal sparkled brilliantly in the midday sunshine. I forgot how beautiful it was, Lyra exclaimed, as if she were on vacation. Just a tourist here to see the Macy's Harvest Balloon Parade and do a bit of shopping on the side. Look, Bon Bon! It's the Crystaller Building! I can't believe it! And I can't believe I didn't know we had a branch of the agency in Manhattan, Bon Bon said, shaking her head. She was not in the mood to check out bridal way shows and visit museums. Makes me wonder what else I don't know, Agent Furlong. Bon Bon raised a suspicious brow.
Plenty. Like what a boner in skinny jeans feels like.
Furlong grunted.
And that's how it has to be, kid.
He looked tired. Maybe he was starting to regret bringing the over-enthusiastic Lyra into all this.
Now stay near me and don't talk to any pony.
He motioned his hoof at them, and the two mares began to follow across the bridge. At the other end, a yellow taxi carriage waited for them. Without a word, Furlong hopped in. Lyra and Bon Bon followed suit, and soon they were whisked into the bustling city streets. The cart rattled through the avenues, making sharp turns and speeding through the traffic signals. As they passed the stockyard exchange, Lyra bounced along with a silly smile on her face. Bon Bon bit her lip in anxious anticipation. This is just the beginning of a bumpy ride, thought Bon Bon. The carriage came to an abrupt halt in front of a hole-in-the-wall joint called Hayes Pizza.
But is it original Hayes, or just one of those knockoff Hayes?
Agent Furlong tossed the driver some bits and hopped out onto the sidewalk. Are we stopping for lunch first? Lyra asked. Because I'm starving.
Yes, we're getting some lunch now.
Furlong replied robotically.
Yum, yum.
He shot Bon Bon a warning look. She finally understood what was happening. It had to be a secret entrance to the new agency digs. Bon Bon grabbed Lyra and pulled her inside.
Just be quiet till we get there, okay? We'll eat later. We have to be discreet.
Oh, okay, Lyra said with a whimper. The smells wafting around inside Haze were so enticing that they made her stomach rumble audibly. A few ponies chowing down on huge, cheesy slices of broccoli pizza looked up at them. She reached her hoof around her tummy to silence it. They stopped at the front counter.
"We're here for a shift, Sauce,"
Furlong called out to a red pony with a tomato cutie mark.
"Ah, right on time. The dough needs kneading in the back."
He tossed them three white aprons stained with tomato sauce and grease. Furlong put one on himself, tossed the other two to Bon Bon, and walked straight back into the kitchen.
"You're doing great,"
Bon Bon assured Lyra, reaching over and tying the apron on Lyra first. After they were both set, they trotted back to the kitchen. Furlong looked impatient. He tapped his hoof on the flour-dusted concrete floor.
"I don't got all day, Drops."
Then Furlong did something quite odd. He quickly looked around, opened the fridge door, and stepped inside. Lyra and Bon Bon exchanged a look before doing the same. Chili crates of tomatoes, mozzarella, and arugula surrounded them, but there was something strange about this room, like it was meant for another purpose. Soon, the floor was moving beneath their hooves. It carried both the produce and the ponies deep into the ground below Manhattan. Light was streaming through two small windows on the sides of the elevator as they passed each level. Ding! The fridge door opened. Lyra and Bon Bon couldn't believe their eyes. There were over 100 ponies, all wearing black, and shuffling around the massive, chrome-colored room. There were rows of desks, mysterious instruments and gadgets, and a massive sign on the back wall that said, "Secret Monster Intelligence League of Equestria, Manhattan Branch. We're everywhere, and we're nowhere." Furlong coughed.
"Welcome to the Manhattan hindquarters of S.M.I.L.E., kids. Please refrain from the butt jokes. I've heard every single one."